Hi and welcome to the channel Love Obstetrics and Gynecology. This video is related to the colposcopy, which basically uses a colposcope to magnify and easily visualize the vulva, vagina and the cervix. This video is basically regarding the cervix, its structure and histology, and how that influences the appearance of cervix on the colposcope. Firstly, talking about the cervical structure. See, cervix is the lowermost portion of this uterus and it is made up of fibromuscular tissue. It is almost conical or cylindrical in shape, almost measuring 3 to 4 cm in length and 2.5 cm in width. The cervix has two parts. So the part that is inside this vagina, this portion, this is known as the portio vaginalis, and the part above it, this portion, this is known as the supravaginal cervix. The cervix has two openings, one towards the uterus, here where the cervix meets with the muscular portion of the body of the uterus. This is known as the internal os. And then we have external os, where the cervix communicates with the vaginal cavity. The part between the internal os and the external os, this part is known as the endocervix, and the part outside this external os in the vagina, this is known as the ectocervix portion. Moving on to the histology, see, the ectocervical lining is made of stratified squamous non-keratinized epithelium. Stratified means there are 15 to 20 cell layers and it is of squamous type, and the keratin tissue is absent, so there is no hardening and it is a mucous membrane lining. The next we have is the endocervix. It is of columnar epithelium. This is the endocervical portion. Here we have a single columnar cell layer lining it. So when we do the colposcopy, there is the incident light and the reflected light. See, we light, put down the light over here on the squamous epithelium. It travels all the way through, and through the stroma it gets reflected back. So it has to pass through many layers. This stroma that is reddish in color would appear as pink if it passes through these many layers. And now here the stroma is very much near to the surface, so here the reflected color will be red. So the squamous epithelium appears as pink, whereas the endocervical layer, that appears as red. The next thing is our squamocolumnar junction. See, the squamocolumnar junction, it appears as a very sharp and a demarcated line because of the height difference between these two ecto and the endocervical linings. Now talking about how this histology is going to affect the appearance of cervix on the colposcopy. See, taking the transverse section of the cervix, or this is how you view your cervix on the colposcope. So basically you will see a circular cervix, and in the center you will have your external os. And now you know that this ectocervical portion is going to appear as pink and the endocervical portion is going to appear as red, and there will be a sharp demarcation line of the squamocolumnar junction. Now regarding the normal appearance of this cervix. Now if we have the patient before menarche, then the squamocolumnar junction, or the original squamocolumnar junction, is near the external os, just near the external os, somewhere over here. And we demarcate it as original squamocolumnar junction, right? Now, there will be puberty, or after menarche, you can say, or in the early reproductive age, this is going to move out. Why? This endocervical lining, this endocervical lining, on the effect of estrogen, there will be eversion of this endocervical lining over the ectocervix. So this endocervical lining is going to move outwards, right? So this squamocolumnar junction will move outwards somewhere over here. And now we will say this as the original squamocolumnar junction, right? So now my squamocolumnar junction is this one. So this is gone, and whole of this area will appear as reddish. So here we have os that has opened up, and whole of this area will appear reddish, whereas this area will appear as pink. Right? Now this columnar epithelium that has everted over the ectocervix, this is going to be affected by the acidic environment. So this acidic environment is going to trigger metaplasia. There will be a squamous metaplasia which starts from this original squamocolumnar junction and moves centripetally inwards, right? And we will have a new squamocolumnar junction somewhere over here. So this reddish portion, this is going to decrease. Over here there will be a squamous metaplasia, which means the reddish portion is limited to this area only, and this is my new squamocolumnar junction. This is my old original squamocolumnar junction, and this area is where there will be a squamous metaplasia. This squamous metaplasia is going to give a pinkish white appearance. This is going to give a reddish appearance, as you have already seen, right? It is going to be consisting of the single columnar epithelium, and my stratified squamous epithelium over here, this is going to give the pinkish appearance. Between this original squamous epithelium and the new squamous epithelium, this area is known as the TZ zone or the transformation zone, where we have the squamous metaplasia. I'm explaining you the same this transverse section or the colposcopic appearance with the histology and how the histology affects its appearance. See, we have the ectocervix. As I've already told you, there will be a stroma below. So the light that gets reflected from the ectocervix gives a pinkish appearance. So this part will be pink in color. The next is my squamous metaplasia area, this area between the original squamocolumnar junction and the new squamocolumnar junction, or also we can say it as the TZ zone, because it consists of maybe the immature squamous metaplasia, or there may be mature squamous metaplasia, or there can be some columnar cells as well in this area between the original and the new squamocolumnar junction. So this area is going to appear as pinkish white, and this area, as we already explained, this is only a single cell layer. So the stroma is very near to the surface, and this is going to appear as red. So this area will be red, this area will be pinkish white, and this area will be pink. Explaining you the different TZ zones or the transformation zones. So if we have the transformation zone 1, now here the transformation zone is completely ectocervical, and you can see the upper limit of the transformation zone, that is the new squamocolumnar junction, quite clearly, and all of this transformation zone is on the ectocervix. So this is my TZ zone 1, this is the type 1 zone, where we have the completely ectocervical TZ zone. This is completely ectocervical, this is going to appear as pinkish white. The inner portion is, this one is reddish columnar epithelium, and this portion is pinkish of the squamous epithelium. Then the next type 2 is, there is a portion endocervical, but that still we can see completely the transformation zone. And over here, we cannot go for the upper margin, upper limit of the transformation zone, which is endocervical. So you won't see a reddish portion in the center if you have such kind of transformation zone, and this is type 3. Let's study this colposcopic appearance on this bone, right? So this is the cervix outline that you can see. Now in the center I am able to appreciate this external os. There is a slit shaped external os, and around that you have the margins like these. This is basically your new squamoclamellar junction, and this is the pinkish white area. All around it is a pinkish white area, and where this pinkish white area merges with the pink color, this is known as your original squamoclamellar junction. And this pinkish area is where your squamous epithelium is. So this is my ectocervical lining, and the inside red portion is the endocervical lining, and I can also appreciate that there is around at 5 o'clock position over here we have a Nabothian follicle, and also the same at 12 o'clock position right over here, and one at 7 o'clock position. You can see these as bright pearly white. So these are my Nabothian follicles. So this next image you can see, this one is your new columnar junction, and this one is your old columnar junction, and over the lower lip there are multiple Nabothian follicles that are present. In this image you can see in the middle you have this your new squamoclamellar junction somewhat like this, and your original squamoclamellar junction is somewhat like this, right? And there is a Nabothian follicle, big Nabothian follicle present over this area, which is shiny also.
Here we have a colposcopic appearance of a transformation zone type 2, where you have the endocervical component of the transformation zone, but still the upper limit is quite clearly visible. In this colposcopic appearance you can see that the cervix we have, this is a TZ3 type, because the TZ zone or the transformation zone is completely endocervical and the upper limit cannot be seen. So if you liked my video, please do like, subscribe and share the channel Love Obstetrics and Gynecology. Thanks for watching.